fan in you guys, Sonakshi Sinha and Dinah Penty. I'm going to start off and be extremely cheesy and ask you guys, what makes you really, 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 really happy?
This cup of chai. Like, I'm dying to have this, that one cup of tea in the evening with the right amount of sugar and the right amount of milk. You know, where it's like really dark like this.
That's some really dark chai, huh? That's also like needed from these rounds of promotional interviews.
I think so, yes. I just finished having my coffee, so yeah, we're good.
So I, you guys haven't had the chance to, but I just stepped in here and it was an absolute swarm of people here to interview these guys. How do you manage to do this? Hour after hour after hour.
I think right now in today's day and age, it's become tougher to promote a film than it is to actually shoot a film.
Yeah.
It's so much more effort, so much more energy that goes into promoting a film. And I guess now, by now we're just kind of used to it. You have to do it, you know, because you want your film to reach out to as many people as possible. And this is the only way that we can ensure that. So yeah, we do it, and the best way to do it, I guess, is to have a positive attitude towards it and have a good time and just be happy.
Yeah, we've actually been having a good time doing this. So
what's a good way to just like psych yourself into enjoying promotions?
I'm gonna do like these cheap plugs of my film every opportunity I get. This is why I roam around in a happy t-shirt, so you just can't miss it.
Even if you weren't listening to what I said.
Happy is coming. Happy Phirr Bhaag Jayegi. Yeah, happy.
True.
But the film is about mistaken identity,
yeah,
and the trailer was good fun. I want to ask you guys, have you ever like disguised yourself ever to get away doing something and in real life and actually pulled it off? Because there's so much you guys can't do being celebrities.
Yeah, but you know, a PCAP is amazing.
Is it?
it is. But
either I've tied my hair up and covered my face half with my PCAP and gone away with murder.
But yeah, sometimes you feel like I hear not so much. But that's why I prefer to like travel and like, you know, where people rarely know you and you can just walk out on the streets freely.
Mm-hmm.
I really enjoy that. But here it gets a little bit impossible to kind of. In Dubai though, I have gone to the mall in a burqa. Yeah, I blended right in.
And what did you do wearing that burqa?
Nothing. I just got to walk around in peace, you know. It was just really nice.
The small joys of
life.
Yeah,
the small joys of life. And I missed that. Before like I started my first film, I used to just go and sit in the food court and waste time for hours with my friends, walk around at my own slow pace, checking out the shops and all. You don't get to do that anymore, man.
What would happen if you do? Like, do you ever still do any of this stuff?
You know, I do.
You do?
Yeah. I don't get, I mean, I'm not as famous as Sonakshi.
So it's true.
I can get away with it. I still do a lot of stuff, especially my side of town, because I feel like people just kind of are less Bollywood crazy downside.
I go Townies.
South Bombay, you know.
And there's no
too
paps.
Too cool for school.
There's no paps that size. So you go to the gym. I just do. I live a normal life. The only thing I stop doing is taking cabs.
Maybe I should move to town. Yeah.
That's your takeaway.
You
take
can
away.
Get away with a lot over there, I promise you.
That actually sounds so nice. Wow. What? I can go to a mall?
Also, yeah. You. But
I
you
can go
guys
to a mall and I can go to the gym in like my oiled hair.
Yeah, but I do. And you guys aren't interested in covering us that side of town, right? Nobody comes crossing the ceiling.
Listen, be careful. Be careful what you wish for. Be careful what you wish for.
So it works out rather well.
Yeah. But you know, I was watching an interview that you did recently. It was a rapid fire and someone asked you, what is the one thing you want to bhag away from?
Yeah.
I'm loving the puns and everything.
Yeah.
And you had said negativity.
Yeah.
So I really want to ask you, have you after all this while in the industry, found a way to not let the scrutiny, the judgment, the trolls get to you and stay happy?
I've always been like that, I think.
Yeah.
And that is something that has really helped me. I feel, you know, growing up as an overweight teenager has not been easy. You get all kinds of flack and kids can be really mean in school, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I had the opposite.
Yeah.
Which people just miss thinking that when you're growing up as a skinny kid, it's like an amazing, right?
People are just so mean, especially in school, your mother didn't come.
Anorexic and all kinds. You'll fly away with the wind.
Yeah.
So it's such a stick.
Yeah. So, okay. Can we come back?
Got her carried away.
Fat kid problems now. So, you know, this camaraderie suddenly is just like throwing me off a little bit. So, yeah, you know it. Kids can be mean. And I've never let even that affect me. In fact, I've always been a very confident person even when I was overweight. So I guess that just kind of helped me to kind of face the things that came my way after I became an actor.
Mm-hmm.
And you are definitely prone to more judgment and more, you know, opinions than anywhere else in the world. If you're in the limelight, if you're an actor, I feel. So it just helps being a positive person and blocking out, you know, all the negative.
But it's also important to read what people have to say because you need to know what they think of you and what's working for your audience and what's not.
It's good to know, but it's also good to not be swayed or affected by it too much.
It would be great. I mean, the best balance would be to take the constructive and work on it, and maybe even,
you know, you guys make it seem so much easier than it actually is. I get one negative comment on my Instagram, I delete it.
Yeah, my mom gets very bothered.
My mother gets so bothered. She calls me and says, block this person.
No, she doesn't even say block. She's like, somebody will comment something, I don't like this dress. See what people are saying. They don't like your dress. I was like, mom, one person said it, relax. It's really okay. Yeah. Stop it. First of all, stop reading my comments. Why are you going through my comments?
Yeah, I don't know. It's a mother thing, I think. Very protective kind of.
Matlab, stop it.
Yeah.
I kind of got immune to it now. It doesn't bother me as much
but
as it used to.
But do you feel not doing as many films has in some level insulated you from the kind of scrutiny? Does it?
Maybe, I guess so.
Yeah.
Which is why I can still walk around and do things.
Soon start doing it and then you also won't be able to. Okay.
Yeah, so to an extent maybe that...
I guess, because, I mean, I would imagine that that would be the reason why I can still do a lot of things.
But you, for instance, I know have your travel, your music, you paint as well. Do each of these things help you not get jaded and therefore be a better actor? Do you like run away to these when showbiz gets too much?
Oh no, I never looked at it. I've gone so deep into it. I do it because I like it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I enjoy sketching, I enjoy painting. It's kind of a time for me to like switch off from everything. Yeah. But the thing is, I do it mostly when I'm super, super tired.
Mm-hmm.
Like I'll come back from a long day at work and I'll just feel like going into my art room and just painting. And that kind of refreshes me. So it's something I do more like, to balance myself. Yeah, but not like to completely switch off and all. They're basically hobbies, right? And everybody needs that in their life. Everybody needs to do something that they truly like enjoy doing. And of course, I enjoy my work and all, but it does get, you know, too much. And it could for anybody.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the things that I turn to when
another thing that you've turned to and enjoyed thoroughly is fitness as well.
Yeah.
You've completely like renewed it with vigor
in
and
the
results are for
past,
everyone
yes,
to see.
Yes, I have shocked myself also.
I love that you said that you did it really for yourself and that's such a lovely way. Have you seen industry perception change
only,
in any way?
That's the only way to do it.
That's the only way to do
it. Even initially when I started losing, like when I was overweight in my college years, everybody used to tell me, lose weight, lose weight, lose weight. I never listened. It only happened when I wanted to do it for myself. And even now, like, I've not been very regular with my workouts, with my food in the past few years. And obviously, also, I was very busy. So I felt like, you know, this is something that can take a backseat because, oh, I'm working. I'm doing so much work. I'm doing good work. So it doesn't really matter. It just happened,
What snapped? What clicked?
What snapped was that my shoot for Happy Phirr Bhaag Jayegi got pushed.
That's
I was sitting at home for 2 months, so I decided to go to the gym.
Oh.
That's it.
It was serious.
Yeah, it was as simple as that. So those 2 months that we had free, I decided to join Pilates, and that really worked for me. I decided to start eating healthier, because when I'm on shoot and all, I eat a lot of junk, like sitting on the set, you know, munching on stuff and all.
Yeah,
so I was at home, so I was eating right, I was eating correct. And that just flipped it and I got hooked onto it because once you start seeing the results, that really motivates you. Yeah, it really motivates you. Yeah.
But have you in any way seen industry perception change towards you when you have a more conventional body image that goes with the Bollywood heroine? Just as of in hindsight?
No, I mean, everybody's really surprised and really happy about the about how I'm looking right now, of course, because obviously it just opens you up to a lot more kind of maybe characters, maybe roles. Yeah, it does. So I mean, everybody's really surprised because they probably also had said that, okay, she's happy the way she is. She's not going to do anything about it. Now when they see that change, they're also happy about it. But other than that, I don't think so. It's not something that I bothered myself much with even in the past. I was, like I said, I was very confident no matter what size I was. And I was doing the roles that I wanted to do. I was working on my own terms and conditions. So it's not something that I put in the forefront.
Okay.
You know, there are other things that matter to me more than how I look.
I'm going to wrap this interview up. You want to tell them why they want to come watch Happy Phirr Bhaag?
Because they just have to. We don't have a choice.
We're not giving them a choice. Because
now there's two happies who get after you if you don't.
We'll come after you if you don't watch the film, 24th August.
Yes.
Thank you so much for chatting with Food Companion. Thanks. Thanks guys for tuning in.